Assume we have a simple linear regression. So simple means you have only one explanatory variable x. And assume that the error term is independently and identically distributed. So that's actually the case in our simulation. So there's no autocorrelation in the error term, and the standard deviation of the error term does not depend on x. That would be heteroscedasticity. And then if you have a single sample of size n, one can estimate the standard deviation of our estimator beta 1 hat. We estimate the standard deviation of beta 1 hat, so it would be standard deviation with a hat of beta 1 hat. That's already a lot of estimations and uncertainties here going on. But one can do this, and statisticians have found that we can use this nice formula for it. So it's 1 over the square root of the sample size n. And that means if we have a larger sample size, the standard error goes down. And if the sample size is multiplied by 4, 4 times as a larger sample, then the square root of 4 is only 2. So the standard error goes only down by a factor of 1/2. And so a larger sample size reduces the standard error. And we also see that if the standard deviation of our error term goes up, actually here we use the standard deviation of the residuals, but that's an estimate of the standard deviation of the error term. If this goes up, our standard error goes larger. That's also what we found in the simulation. We can less precisely estimate the beta 1 if the use fluctuate more. And we also see if the standard deviation of x goes up, then the standard deviation of beta 1 hat goes down. So if you have more variation in the explanatory variable, we can more precisely estimate beta 1. So that's all pretty much in line with our simulations. And there are also formulas for these standard errors. If we have more than one explanatory variable, so a multiple linear regression, but they involve matrix notation, which I don't want to introduce here. One can also relax the assumption that the error terms are independently or identically distributed. Then one has to use so-called robust standard errors. And a lot of econometric papers have been written about robust standard errors. Let me just note that there are R functions that conveniently also can compute robust, run linear regressions with robust standard errors, like LM robust in the package estimator, or the function FELM in the package LFE. But we don't really discuss robust standard errors in detail here, but in a lot of empirical papers, you should use robust standard errors. But so if we come to an application, we come back how to do this and which sort of robust standard errors may be a good idea here. Here are more graphical illustrations of the distribution of our estimator beta 1 hat, here for a sample size of 20, and here for a sample size of 80, using the simulation we have done before. You see that the distribution basically always gets more closely around this true value of beta 1, which is equal to 1. So do you think that if the sample size grows larger and larger, basically our estimator beta 1 hat converges in distribution or probability to this true value beta 1? Or do you think that there's kind of always a little bit variation left and it doesn't go below some level, so there will always be some minimum level of noise even if our sample size goes up to infinity?